Hey friends, how you doing today? I actually have a question for you all. For those who live local or who come into New York City often to see a musical, what is your reason for seeing a show? Why don't you see certain shows? What do you feel about ticket prices? What do you feel about the quality of musicals today? I kind of want audience feedback on this one in the comments. I'm going to put a graphic here, okay? I pulled all these numbers from all the grosses for the last 10 years. I know 2020 and 2021, we had like a complete loss of everything. That was a pandemic. That's because of COVID. If you look at 2022 and 2023, if you look at the far right column, you know, it tells you the percentage of the difference between the total seats available for sale and then how many seats sold. So it divides the number of seats sold by the number of tickets and multiply by 100, and then you get the average how full the theaters are. 89% is not terrible. I mean, that was back in 2018, we were around the same, and 2019 we're at 90%. So I mean, like, attendance wise we're doing we're kind of getting back to it, but you know, you look at the grosses, we're shy like $300 million in 2023 compared to like 2019 and 2018. So I'm wondering, because I see a lot of sales going on. I see a lot of like, ooh, discount tickets, $25 ticket. Like, they're trying to get people in to see the shows. So I'm just kind of wondering how this is going. Also, the number of performances, 11,000 so far this year. And granted, we still have like a few weeks left of 2023, so these numbers are probably going to go up a little bit. I think New York City is having some kind of congestion tax that they're implementing. If you're driving into New York City and you're below 60th Street, which is most of the Broadway shows, you're going to get taxed just for driving in that part of the city. And I'm like, well, that was that going to deter people? What do you think of these numbers? Please interpret them. I'm not a statistician. I did take statistics in college. Doesn't make me an expert. It's just interesting to see these figures and to see that, you know, Broadway is nowhere near pre-pandemic levels. Now, I'm really looking at 2019 and 2018 for pre-pandemic levels, because with inflation and everything, a dollar in 2013 is different value than today. So, you know, looking at those grosses aren't really a clear picture. But even just looking at, you know, 2019, 2018, is it because they had more shows performing on Broadway? Don't forget, also Phantom closed. So, you know, you're missing out. That theater's just kind of being rebuilt and vacant. I just want feedback from an audience and people who love theater and who go see shows often, what your take is on some of this. You could find these figures. I just put it in a spreadsheet to make it easier to read year by year. But you could find all these on Broadway World, on Broadway League grosses. You could, you know, kind of do it yourself. But I just kind of curated it this way and aggregated all the data in one place to make it easier to read and, you know, compare year over year. Man, 2020 and 2021 really fucked Broadway, didn't it? Look at those. Look how much money has been lost. You've lost like $1 billion 2 years in a row. That's really sad, actually. Just how much work was lost during that time. But I'm glad it's kind of rebounding a little bit here as far as attendance. Hope you all have a great week. I want your feedback.
Feedback.
I do read most of the comments. Talk to you soon. Bye.